हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडेज टॉपिक इज यूनिट क्वांटिटीज ऑफ टरबाइन। इन दिस सेशन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द यूनिट स्पीड, यूनिट डिस्चार्ज, यूनिट पावर विथ द टरबाइन। सो हियर यूनिट क्वांटिटीज ऑफ टरबाइन। अ टरबाइन ऑपरेट्स मोस्ट एफिशिएंट एट इट्स डिजाइन पॉइंट एट ए पर्टिकुलर कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ हेड, डिस्चार्ज, स्पीड एंड पावर आउटपुट, बट इन एक्चुअल प्रैक्टिस हार्डली एनी टर्बाइन ऑपरेट्स एट इट्स डिजाइन पैरामीटर्स। इन ऑर्डर टू प्रिडिक्ट द बिहेवियर ऑफ ए टर्बाइन वर्किंग अंडर वेरिंग कंडीशंस ऑफ हेड, स्पीड एंड पावर, रिकोर्स हैज बीन मेड टू द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ यूनिट। द यूनिट क्वांटिटीज गिव द स्पीड, डिस्चार्ज एंड पावर फॉर अ पर्टिकुलर टर्बाइन अंडर अ हेड ऑफ 1 मीटर, एज्यूमिंग द सेम इफिशेंसी। द फॉलोइंग आर द 3 important unit quantities here. First one is unit speed, second one is unit power, third one is unit discharge. So first here we will discuss about the unit quantities, that is unit speed. This is represented by NU, the speed of the turbine working under unit head, say 1 meter, is known as the unit speed of the turbine. Here we know that speed ratio Ku is equal to U divided by V. U is the blade velocity, V is the jet velocity. From this equation we get here U is directly proportional to V, and we also know that V is equal to under root 2gh. Here 2gh. From this equation we get V is directly proportional to under root h. Therefore from these two equation we get U is directly proportional to under root h. But we also know that U is equal to pi dn divided by 60. Now by eliminating the constant value, that is pi divided by 60, here we get U is directly proportional to d into n. For a given turbine the diameter is constant, so from this equation we get here n is directly proportional to u, but we already here derived u is directly proportional to under root h. Now putting the value here in this equation, then we get n is directly proportional to under root h. Therefore, by eliminating the proportionality, taking the constant, we get n is equal to k1 into under root h. Now, from definition of unit speed, if h is equal to 1 meter, then speed will equal to nu, that is unit speed. Putting this value in this equation, we get here nu is equal to k1. Then putting this value in this equation, that is k1 value is equal to nu in this equation, then we get here nu is equal to n divided by under root h, and this equation is known as the unit speed of the turbine. Now we have come to the second unit quantity, that is unit discharge. This is represented by Qu. The discharge of the turbine working under a unit head, say 1 meter, is known as the unit discharge. Total discharge, we know that Q is equal to area of flow into velocity of flow, but for a given turbine area of flow is constant, therefore Q is directly proportional to flow velocity, and we know that flow velocity is directly proportional to under root h. Therefore, taking the proportionality constant, we get here Q is equal to k K2 into under root H from definition of unit discharge. If H is equal to 1 meter, then Q will equal to unit discharge QU. Therefore, we get QU is equal to K. Putting this value in this equation, here we get QU is equal to K2. Now, this value K2 is put in this equation and we get here QU is equal to Q divided by under root H, and this equation is known as the unit discharge for the turbine. Now we have come to the last unit quantity, that is a unit power. This is represented by PU. The power developed by the turbine working under a unit head, say 1 meter, is known as the unit power of the turbine. The overall efficiency, we know that this is the ratio of shaft power to the water power. Now here P is the shaft power divided by water power is equal to rho g QH divided by 1000. Therefore, from this equation we get P is directly proportional to overall efficiency into rho g QH divided by 1000. Therefore, P is directly proportional to QH by eliminating here all constant parameter, that is rho g into overall efficiency divided by 1000. We get here P is directly proportional to QH. But we also know that Q is equal to here, Q is equal to area of cross section into flow velocity here. But area of cross section is constant, so Q is directly proportional to flow velocity. But we also know that flow velocity is directly proportional to under root H. Then putting this value in this equation, here we get P is directly proportional to under root H into H here. Therefore, P is directly proportional to H ki power 3/2. Therefore, eliminating by proportionality constant, we get here P is equal to K3 into H ki power 3/2. Now, from definition of unit power, if H is equal to 1 meter, then here this is P is equal to PU, that is unit power of the turbine. Therefore, putting this value in this equation, we get here PU is equal to K3. It means we get here K3 is equal to PU. Now, putting this value in this equation, we get here PU is equal to P divided by H ki power 3/2. This equation is known as the unit power of the turbine. Now, class is over. Thank you for listening.